Hello, welcome to Manchester United News Channel.
Manchester United fans are getting impatient, because the club have not signed anyone in the transfer window yet, but they are being unrealistic. If it hasn't already, the Manchester United Twitter account might want to tick every box listed under mute notifications from people, as well as the quality filter. Any post from United is greeted with announce De Ligt or announce James, and next week, if they are linked with someone they might or might not sign, their name will replace De Ligt's and James's. United supporters are desperate for good news, and the announcement of someone, anyone, is usually positive. Even if it is Lee Grant, a signing confirmed 10 minutes before kick-off between England and Colombia in the World Cup. The 36-year-old remains United's last signing. The club tried to lift the gloom with a season ticket renewal record, and that drew more scorn. There are no imminent contract announcements, and, however cynical fans and punters were amid the treble nostalgia, the buoyant reunion game offered escapism. United's only summer announcements so far have been the new Adidas kit, and a friendly with Norwegian side Kristiansund in Oslo. They do not set the pulses racing, but fans' impatience is a theme of transfer windows. They need their fix and are clucking. Senior United sources stress the preference is to conclude deals by the end of May, but that is idealistic. United have not moved that quickly and diligently since the summer of 2007, when they agreed deals for Nani and Anderson during a Lisbon day trip, abetted by Portuguese speaker Carlos Queiroz. The next day, United reported an agreement with Bayern Munich for the transfer of Owen Hargreaves, but a dot the previous summer. For United were only consigned to a Europa League campaign on May 5. Former manager Jose Mourinho actually compiled two transfer lists in 2017, depending on whether United qualified for the Champions League or not. United made an 11th-hour inquiry for Julian Brandt less than 2 weeks ago, before he left Bayer Leverkusen for Borussia Dortmund. Then there is the international calendar. Almost 4 weeks will have elapsed between Paul Pogba's and Scott McTominay's starts against Cardiff, and their national team's European Championship qualifying fixtures. Harry Maguire and Declan Rice have already trotted out the cliché about being focused on international commitments amid speculation over their futures, but it is true. United's negotiations with Pogba in 2016 were held up partially, because agents were banned from France's hotels during the European Championship. United might not announce James until mid-June. His father passed away suddenly last week, and James left the Wales training squad in Portugal, but he is available to play against Croatia on June 8 and Hungary on June 11. Both ties are in Eastern Europe. Last year, United were able to conduct Fred's medical before he left for the World Cup in Russia, because Brazil played a friendly against Croatia at Anfield in early June. Deals for Fred and Diogo Dalot were effectively done in May, since they had release clauses. James does not, but the deal should happen. The early May deal for Memphis Depay in 2015 was necessitated by interest from Paris Saint-Germain and Liverpool, and Van Gaal intervened. Pogba did not become a United player again until his coast-to-coast sojourn in the United States and Hargreaves put pen to paper a month after the club website's communique.